study number one now.
Excited, strapped into the belly of this great, shaking, noisy, mechanical bird. Hey, just look down there. Nothing but grey, heaving, cold ocean. Swimming wouldn't be much use if we fell in that. No, I'm really rather excited about our journey, though. There aren't many people who've been to our destination. It's a funny thing about the place we're going to. Without it, and other places like it, there wouldn't be any helicopters working anywhere in the world. In fact, there'd be no journeys by any kind of machine. Helicopter, bicycle, or whatever. The fact is, all machines need fuel to drive them, or oil to make them run smoothly, or both. And we certainly wouldn't be making our trip across the sea in this machine without oil and fuel. We're on our way to see one of the places that oil and fuel come from.
We've come 160 kilometers from the nearest land to find out how our country is getting the fuel and oil that it needs to keep machines like helicopters and cars and trains and factories working. Coming? We're on what the oil men call a drilling rig. This one's even got a name like a ship. It's called the Dundee King's North, and it's working right out here. In the middle of the North Sea. Well, that's the stretch of cold and dangerous water that separates the British Isles from Europe and the Scandinavian countries. So, what are we doing here, so far away from the nearest land? Well, in a way, we're fishing. Fishing for fuel, that is.
On a drilling rig, you don't take risks. Danger lurks everywhere. Below the sea, freezing cold and hundreds of meters deep. Above, men and machines that could drop heavy metal parts on your head at any time.
Some reading about oil before I came out here to find out about it. And apparently, there are lots and lots of different kinds of oil, but they all have one thing in common. They all come from the same place. And it's the same place that gives us another important fuel, coal. Well, you can guess where that is then, can't you? Well, like coal, oil comes from under the ground. It's what was left when rotting plants and dead animals got squashed between layers of rocks. And then they were crushed and squeezed for millions of years. the oil we've found so far is in a very awkward spot. Not only is the oil under the ground is under the sea as well. Oil, under the ground, under the sea. Oh, and it's a nasty cold deep sea into the bargain, the North Sea. So getting at our oil is a big problem, because no one knows where it is, only that it's down there somewhere. So all they can do is poke around until they find it. And that's exactly what the Dundee Kings North is doing, poking around on the bed of the North Sea to find oil. So let's go and talk to someone about it. John Pickles, and he's chief man on this oil rig. But I see on your hat your label says you're a barge master. Oh, what's that?
Well, that basically means that I'm captain. Captain of the ship. Captain of the ship when it is a ship, when it's working as a ship. At the moment, it's working as a drilling rig. Basically, we have an idea that there is oil down below where we're drilling, and we just go ahead and we drill a hole. Remember looking back when I was a young lad starting at sea, I thought, I'll be captain of a ship. And this is a ship, you see.
John went on to explain how he turns the ship into a drilling rig. A transparent model helps the story. When it gets to its destination, John's first job is to anchor it firmly in position. Then he fills the lower part of the ship with seawater, slowly making it heavier and heavier. Eventually, the weight of all that extra water begins to make the ship sink. But because of its shape, it doesn't go right to the bottom. Well, that was a real shock to me.
Well, I realised from the noise that we're drilling, but I didn't actually realise that we were floating.
Oh, yes, we're floating, but we're floating very, very deep.
But, I mean, look at the sea. Why aren't we just bobbing around like a cork?
Because there's 70 feet of the rig under the water. We do this because the bottom of the rig is in still water where it's not affected by the weather, and therefore the rig doesn't roll around.
So half sinking the rig steadies it for the work of drilling. John explained that was its real task, to lower a huge drill bit, a cutting tool, to the bottom of the sea ready to bite into the rocks down there. A special undersea television set shows the amazing moment when the drill reaches the sea floor, down among the fishes. Work begins. The drill turns, but it's no ordinary job it has to do. Just think how silly it seems to be trying to make a hole in solid rock. Anyone could tell him what would happen. A drill, there are difficulties. And remember, some rocks are much harder than a brick wall. What's the problem this time? The drill needs to be kept cool if he's going to make that hole any deeper. Wet and slippery mixture will save it from burning up or wearing out. No heat now. The drill turns. The hole gets deeper. But there is a price. That's the price the oil men must pay. Their drill needs wet, slippery mud to keep it turning coolly. The mud makes their lives a misery. It's pumped down to the drill, gallons of it spill. It's only the lucky few who escape the mess. last long. This drilling tool must be changed. It's being unscrewed from the end of the drill pipe. It's heavy, back-breaking work. One slip on the drill deck can mean a serious accident. In the cold and wet, handling that heavy steel can easily mean a squashed finger, or worse. The new cutting bit goes into place. Soon it will be turning in the rock, almost 4,000 meters below the seabed, searching out oil that might be there. North can clean up a bit and relax, but it won't be long before they must attend to their drill again. There's nothing. But the work goes on, and so does life on the Dundee King's North. Successful. This ship is a tanker, sailing off to a place where oil has been found. A place where it can pick up the precious liquid fuel that has been fished up from deep beneath the seabed. That's where we're going too. It's another man-made island. Almost everyone who comes does so like us, by helicopter. By helicopter, it's an hour away from the nearest land. it look easy. The real job is almost impossible. A monstrous tower built of steel is floated out to where the oil is. The tower is as tall as a skyscraper, and it weighs as much as a huge ship. They tip it over until it stands up firmly on the bed of the sea, and then they fix it, for it must withstand all the battering the sea can give.
And in weather conditions like today, that's not a bad thing, because it prevents it and us from floating away like a ship. Anyway, the man who knows what's going on here is called Dick O'Dell.
Dick, can you explain to us what happened on a permanent platform?
Well, the idea of a platform such as this gives us the opportunity to drill several wells from one location.
Dick, do you think you can show